Hi, I usually make videos in French, but I wanted this one to be in English because the topic is so important that I wanted everyone to understand it. I am a French gypsy jazz player. I live in Paris and I play in a lot of jam sessions, and I also go every year to Samoa, the Django Reinhardt Festival. And I've noticed something that everybody does, almost everybody does, when playing the chords of Coquette. Almost everybody plays it this way. So a D major and then a D sharp diminished. As I transcribe a lot of Django Reinhardt solos, maybe you saw them on Soundslice, and also the chords played in Django tunes, I've noticed that Django doesn't play it this way. He doesn't play a D sharp diminished or a B7. It's almost the same chord. The chords that you can hear in the only version of Coquette he recorded, which was in 1956 in London, the chords can be played this way. Etc. So my point here is to focus on this chord, D major, and then this chord, and the bass player every time plays an F. So this chord is an F diminished chord, which can also be played this way on the guitar, but it's not this chord. This diminished chord is the, I call it the one diminished chord. It's the same you already played probably on I Can Give You Anything But Love. It's this chord who goes to the second chord, the A minor. But in Coquette, it goes to this chord, which is an E minor. It can be played this way, but they play it this way, and E minor, A7. E minor at A7. The problem is, if you play this tune with someone who plays this chord and you play this one, it won't fit. It won't work. Also, this chord is much more typical of swing music in the 30s, and this one is more like a classical jazz turnarounds from the 50s, maybe bebop, probably. But this one is so typical, and it sounds to me, it sounds so nice that it's a shame that nobody plays it. So, when you play Coquette the next time, use this chord and not this one before the E minor. So how can we play Coquette? What chords can we play? Oh, just before that, let me tell you, I just released an album. It's called Paris Music Tales. It's gypsy jazz compositions. You can hear it on Spotify. You can buy it on Bandcamp. You can go on our YouTube channel. We have videos of Paris with our music. We also have everything is transcribed, so you can buy the charts, the tabs of every tune. So please go check it out. Let's go back to Coquette. Here is a way I like to play this tune. I use this chord for the first one, then for the F diminished. So the F is played by the bass player, but I play this D diminished. Then to E minor, I play it this way, with the 7th on the bottom, then A7, again E minor 7, A7, and just before the last D, I go to this A7. This one is a A9. And this is better for better resolution on the D major. And then the turnaround. This D major, to me, is better for resolution than this one that I use for starting the tune. I have this string muted. For the B section, you can play A minor 7 and D7, or only D7. Django only plays the D7, and then G major with a 6th. then E7 and only A7, no E minor. It's not really a big mistake if you play it, but it's better to play only A7. So let's play this version of Coquette. 1, 2, 3, 4. Of course, there are other ways to play the chords of Coquette, but what's really important is that every chord sounds well when they are played together. For example, if you play this, and then this chord for E minor, the top melody of the chord will be. To me, it doesn't sound so well because it doesn't sound like D major. Maybe this one, or maybe this one, or maybe this one for E minor, but not this one if you play this chord before. But if you play this, sounds good. So you have to be very precise and to choose chords that fit together and sound good together. And try to listen to the top melody of your chords. It has to be a nice melody. So please use this F diminished chord. It really sounds amazing. I use it a lot in my composition. For example, I have a composition called Charme Discret in E major. It's the same chords that in Coquette, but in E major, with an E major 7. I really hope this video helped you guys. The next time you go to a jam session, ask for this chord and not this one. If some musicians tell you you are wrong, ask them to go see this video, which title should be explicit enough. And also ask them to listen more carefully to the tune Coquette of Django and the chords in this tune.